Hi everybody, this is just going to be a quick tutorial on how to set up AWS SQS on Forge. I was asked to do this at work today and it took me quite a bit of trial and error to get it working, so I thought if I can save somebody else a few minutes setting it up, then I might as well make a video. So the first thing that you're going to want to do is make sure that you're on AWS, make sure that you're on the right zone that you want to put. Like if you've got your website in Ireland, then you want your queue in Ireland as well. So that's what I've got. So if you select Ireland and then you can type in here SQS, and then just click Get Started if you've not already created one. And then what you want to do is put a queue name in here. So I just put test queue and then just leave it as a standard queue and then click create. And then I'll just show you my code that I've altered slightly in Sublime. So this is in config and then queue. I've just changed these variables slightly from what you get when you first install Laravel. I'll explain what each one is later, but if you just copy down and change yours the same as this, and then I'll just show you my .env file. So the first thing you want to do is change the queue driver to SQS. I think it's synced as default, and then you need to change these two. These are the three that I've added that aren't there by default. So you need your AWS key. There's five things that I've added that aren't there by default. So if you add your AWS key and secret, which you can get by, if you go to if you go to this IAM, you can create a user and give it permission to access the queue, and you'll get a secret token. So you put those two in there. These are just made up ones, these are not my actual keys. And then because I've chosen Ireland, the region for that is EU West 1. If you Google AWS regions, you can find out a list of all the different region codes. And then the SQS prefix, which is this part. So we just need to look. Just close that. So if we click on this test queue, you can see at the bottom here you get a few details about the queue. So what we're interested in for this property is up to the last slash. So if you just copy up to that zero, paste that in there without a slash on the end, and then the SQS queue name is just this bit on the end that we named test queue, and just leave out that last slash. And that's it pretty much for the code. So if you commit that and then deploy to your server, and then when you get onto Forge, I've just spun up an instance just to demonstrate what to enter in. So when you click on the queue tab on the site section, you want to put in SQS, and then this is the bit that caught me out. Usually you just leave this as default, but with SQS you've got to delete that altogether and leave it blank. And then I just usually put this as 1000 or something. You can leave all these are all optional. I usually do one for this. And then you can put production just so that it runs the queue as production. And then if you tick this, run workers daemon. The only thing with this is that when you deploy your code, you need to restart the queue, because when you run the worker as a daemon, it saves the old version of your code until you restart it. So if you make changes to your backend code and you don't restart the queue, it's going to be running an old version of your code. So then you just press start worker, and then it'll just start doing that. It might not work on this because I've not actually got any code deployed. So then when you do... demonstrate that. Basically, in your deploy script, if you look at on the docs near the bottom, you just need to add this to your deploy script, whether it's in Forge or Envoy or whatever you're using to deploy your code. You just need to make sure that it restarts at the end, just to get the fresh version of your code. And that's pretty much it. Hopefully this helped you save a bit of time. If it did, please like and subscribe, and I'll try and bring some new videos every week at least. Thanks.